Hey everybody, it's Jang here with a look at the 2010 version of the LEGO ARC-170 Starfighter, only the second of two minifig scale versions of this New Republic and Clone Wars era icon that LEGO ever made. I've previously reviewed the first one that they did 5 years before this in 2005, and I'm going to take a look at this, and in a separate video I will do a head-to-head, side-by-side comparison between the two. Overall, I think that this is looking pretty smooth and pretty modern. It went together quite well. I feel like it's pretty durable, which is tough to pull off with such thin wings. I mean, the wings themselves are really just a single plate thick with just some other plates and tiles that are used to hold those together. But they really, really kept them as thin as they could. And it does still have the working S-foil action, so you can actually change the angles of the upper and lower wings. I'll go ahead and show you that right now, because that is a very important thing here. It's got the little gear at the back, and this is really geared down in this version. You have to turn and turn. And eventually, S-foils come out into their fully open position. It's a cog or a cam system that they use in there. I'll go ahead and retract it. You can see the blue rubber bands, but as I retract this, see how that center assembly with the yellow bushing at the end of it is rotating. It's rotating around. This has a gearbox down in the center of it that you put together very early on, which uses a worm gear, which is why it is geared down just so much. And you can actually just continue turning that and it'll start to open up. There's no stopper on that, because the cam can just continue to rotate around. This one does have the proper tail gun set up with a gun on the bottom, one up on the top. Tail gunner position right here. Of course, all of the canopies open up, and this is able to be posed, but the two go together like so. It's kind of simple looking. You know, it doesn't really look like a proper gun setup. And unfortunately, this is a little bit loose back here. You can kind of make that tighter, push these together, push these couple pieces here, get a little bit of friction in it, so you get, you know, a little bit better posability. But it's much nicer to actually have these than to not. Got a sticker down in there, which is actually a really good looking sticker for the console for the rear gunner's position. And then you've got the one up front for the forward gunner and weapons officer. These are done pretty nicely. The engine areas, even though, you know, they have to leave this a little bit open in the center in order to have the mechanism that actually works there. These pieces actually have stickers on them. This is a nice little embedding of a couple pieces together. You can rotate these around if you want to. I think that's actually kind of cool looking, but it's not supposed to be the intent. One sticker just used right here. This is all built up pretty properly. They did a pretty nice job with the nose as well. Overall, I'm pretty satisfied with this thing from a play value perspective and a look perspective, and the build also. Like I said, the build was pretty solid. The only, you know, negative thing here is that, you know, once you get the wings into S-foils, you know, attack position, it doesn't really pose very well anymore. You can't just leave it like that on the ground. But I wouldn't actually ding it for that, because in the real Star Wars world, it would never land like that. If you do want to pose it like this, since it does look so much better to have those S-foils locked open, you know, it's just a more impressive display, then you just need to supply some sort of stand, which you can build out of any kind of pieces that you want. But all told, I'm pretty happy with the look of this thing, the function of it, and how it's assembled. Even the guns out here are assembled in a way that just uses few enough pieces, and they're attached well enough. I think they did a good job of picking the overlaps. That's actually a little bit more difficult than it appears generally, to figure out exactly how to set that up to have the maximum amount of clutch power, because you can get a little bit more or a little bit less clutch power depending upon exactly how many things you overlap. And here you've got two pieces that these are being connected into. Bottom line is, it all stays together quite well. There's one other action that I haven't shown you. This does have a pair of flick fire missiles hidden down underneath here, And you can activate those by pushing on the gear back here. This is actually able to slide forward and back, so it's just a remote activation for those. But the only thing that's bad about those is that they can't go very far, because you've got this whole area of nose that just sticks down here, and that's just in line. So basically, those will go out partway, and then they start to come down. So they're not going to shoot completely straight forward, but they're intended to be looking more like proton torpedoes that would not be just going completely straight. They would kind of, you know, come off, and then they would fly off on their own. And just for the sake of play, you just end up having to kind of aim up, and then they will come out, they'll hit this, and then they'll kind of shoot down a bit. Turning attention to the figures left to right, it's Jedi Kit Fisto, Captain Jag, a generic clone pilot, and then this astromech is R4P44. And the difference between Captain Jag and the regular pilot is just in the print on the head, or actually on the helmet. The heads underneath are actually the same. They just have the blue. I'll go ahead and lean that forward so you can see a little bit better the difference between the prints on those. Very nice and sharp prints on them, looking pretty good. The R4 unit is basically an R2 that's just been recolored in a dark silver color and dark green. Kit Fisto has a head that is all rubbery. He's only been in three regular sets on the whole as a full usable minifigure. Only two sets had him with this exact configuration here without the cloak. And the other one's Palpatine's Arrest, where he had the cloak on. No print on the back of Kit Fisto's body, but putting his head back on, you see they do have good detailing with what comes down from the head. And for your two pilots, no secondary faces for either of those, but I do want to give you just a little bit better look at what their faces look like here with the kind of simulated visor coming across the front, the heads-up display in orange. It's supposed to be part of the helmet assembly. The three of them look pretty good, tucked into their proper positions in the craft. The R2 or R4 unit's head just pokes out there. And you got your rear gunner. All works pretty well. There's just no good place to store Kit Fisto's lightsaber on the ship, unfortunately. Good stuff. Seems like a good improvement over the previous version, but like I said, stay tuned for my comparison video between those two. And in the meantime, go ahead and leave a comment on the video if you'd like to with your thoughts about this set. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.